that's my attempt. Fair enough. Okay, so we were talking about the data types. We were trying to find out what is the class that the data type is belonging to, what is the class that it is belonging to, and how we can convert the data type from one data type to another data type. That's what we were trying to do. So we were talking about, I think last class we were talking about creating the factor. What is this factor is all about? Factor is a variable, is a data type where, not variable, is a data type where you can define the data in such a way, you can define the data in levels, which is not the case with respect to the C or Java. So if you want to have this kind of data type, you have to define a class structure, you have to define a data structure in C or in Java, whatever it is. And again, you have to do some kind of manipulation or some kind of coding around that to really figure out what levels are it is, or levels. So let's run this part. I'm defining a variable gender. I know we discussed this part. Once again, to recap it, there are two genders I'm defining here as a male and female. And I'm using a C function to concatenate this data point. And I want to define this data as a factor. So gender is a factor variable which has two levels. What are the two levels? Male is one level, female is one level. So when I run this command, see here below, when I run this command, the system executed it. And the moment you type gender, it immediately showed you male, female. That means what are the values this particular data type contains, and it suggested that how many levels it has. That means how many times that particular value has been repeated, that repetition part it is representing here as a level. Since this is, if I repeat this for, let's say, again, I'm copying this only F, okay. And I simply keep on adding. Still, if I do this, my levels are only two only. But you see the values, it showed you all the values, but levels are going to be two only. Hope this is clear. Any doubts, please? Okay. So you may be thinking in your mind, what is this, in what situation this is going to help? In the data science, when you're trying to look into the data file, you may have lot of data that will be appearing in one particular column. And I wanted to know how many levels in that column. These are thousands and thousands of data will be there in one particular column when you look into like Amazon or Flipkart, such kind of company data. So finding out the levels of the that any column is also important. So now there is a command called levels. Try these things. Levels gender, automatically it is telling me, it is showing me what are the levels here. And there is something called n levels. Then what happens is, if you run this, it will tell you how many number of levels it has. It has two levels, but here, okay. Sometimes what you have to do, you have to generate the levels. You have the data and you are trying to classify the data into some levels. This we will talk about when we do the classification in the, what you call, data modeling, okay. So during that, we are trying to segregate the data into different levels on certain criteria, based on certain criteria. So how do I do that? There is a command called generate levels, which you call it as GL. Generate level basically tells you what levels we wanted to generate. So let me run this. So I have defined a variable called level generation, which means level generations, and running the command GL. and something I defined in the, within the parenthesis 3 comma 10, which I defined it, which means if I use this legend, see here, I'm looking at 3 levels, but each level I wanted that to be repeated by 10 times. So what it is doing is, level 1 it is generating 10 times, 2 is generated 10 times, and 3 is generated 3 times. System by default it is taking this information. To make you to clarify this from that standpoint, suppose if I put it as a 5 here, then you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You see that? Did you get what I'm trying to say? Please respond. Did you get what I'm trying to say? Yes? Okay. So now, why 1, 2, 3? System by default, I did not mention anything here that the system has to start from 1 and then go with generate the 3 levels. But that is how the GL command understands and generates the information. Here, there is another thing. Instead of number, I want to generate the levels using the alphabet. Okay. But it is not going to make any sense if I define the level at a alphabet level, because by default system will be level 7. We are looking at one, whether level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. We never say level A, level B, level C. Right? So when I try to run this command, it gives you error. Please remember this. Please note this. When you try to generate the level using your alphabet and trying to repeat, here in this command, I'm trying to generate the level A. Generate the levels for A times, at least each one repeating 12 times. That is what it is here, right? I want to generate the 3 levels starting from 1, and each one is repeated by 10 times. So that is not going to happen. Look at this. Automatically, when we are talking about GL, right? When you generate the GL, this variable is by default is a fact belonging to factor class. That is why when this example has been shown, class legend, automatically it is showing you factor variable. So not necessarily that you have to use the factor to define this. You can use the GL also and define the variable, which will become a class type factor. Am I okay? Is that clear to you? Now the question comes. I don't want the system to take 1, 2, 3 and generate the levels. Rather, I would like to define my own stuff. Till also you can do this. So I'm defining a variable, fact 1, of type factor, because I'm using GL function. And now I wanted to pass parameters and trying to control my level. So if I do this, the system is going to generate something like this. You see here, there are only 2 levels it is generating. I am specifying my length equal to 6. Please be with me. Let me repeat the statement in a different way. Let's say I will do this for 9 instead of. Just watch out this. Did you get what this system is doing? Did you get what the system is doing? What it is doing is, system by default it is taking level 1 from 1 onwards. What it is telling is, I am only interested in generating 2 levels, and each level is repeated 3 times, but the total number, the total values of the levels are going to be 9. Here it is only 6. That means only 6 times this will be repeated. Here 9 times. So since the constraint here is only 2 levels I am interested in, that is 1 and 2, but my length of the variable is actually 9. So after repeating the 1 for 3 times and 2 for 3 times, again it will actually take the 1 and repeat for the 3 times, because the length is defined as 9. If I do it for, let's say, instead of 9, okay, now I will say 7, because I am telling the system that 3 times it has to repeat. Any one level that I repeat, it has to be done by 3 times, repeat by 3 times, and level should be division of this 3. Because now if I say 7, let's see what it happens, what it creeps about it. So system happily takes it without any problem. So this is something like an interview question to you to confuse you that this is not going to happen. This example, for sure you will get a question, this question in your interview, or in your, when they give you the written examination, this question, there will be a question on this.